Where's Hattie?
She's supposed to be making, but she didn't turn up.
If someone you love goes and kills somebody, you'd know straight away, wouldn't you? You can't hide something like that.
What makes you think she's dead?
If her leave me.
You would know if your dad was a killer.
I told you not to look in that bag!
It's just a shift that went bad, that's all.
I need you on my side, Fee.
I'm always on your side.
Fine, I'll find the little bitch.
She's a child, Malcolm.
You have no idea. You want to search the woods.
We're going to find a magic circle.
Is it Hattie's?
It's a May Queen crown.
Seth!
What have you done?
You know what I've done.
Flowers is definitely hers. But why would she be out there?
Doing what kids do.
No, not Hattie, no. Seth, he spends a lot of time in the woods, doesn't he?
Not really. He's got his own flat now. He's sorted. Anyway, he was at the parade. I doubt if he knows anything.
Of course he was, yeah.
Seth's not here.
Shut up.
Where have you been?
Who are they? And why have you got it? Where did this come from?
Scratch it.
What the hell was that?
Hello, police? The police, can you open up, please? The police? Can you open up, please? Hello, police?
I'll get the door then.
Don't move!
Hello, police, can you hear me? Is anyone there? Can you open up, please?
Happy now?
Far from it. What have you done to her?
Her?
Take her away. You make the whole town unhappy. It's all right, love.
You're mad, Steve.
I'll get you out. I'm here. Ow! Hattie! Hattie! You stole a cat. I saw you yesterday wearing a crown of flowers. Where is she? Are you keeping her in the woods?
Have you ever been buried alive? I have. I've lain under the leaves and listened to the worms.
Stay here, but don't move. Hello, my name is Steve Docker and I'm calling regarding my brother.
Seth Docker, he's having a major exercise to update someone from the crisis team here now.
How come? James, is your father there?
No.
Oh. Well, you're going to have to come over now.
I can't, Mum. I've got an appointment.
No, you have to cancel your appointment. This is important.
Why? What's going on?
Well, he went out looking for a missing child last night and I haven't seen hide nor hair of him since.
Have you tried calling him?
Yeah, of course I have, but I just keep getting voicemail.
Who's missing?
Hattie Sutton.
I'll make them wait for more than an hour, Mum.
Where have you been?
Make me wait more than an hour.
Thanks, Mum. Mum, do you have to watch me eat?
Oh, no, I just like seeing you happy.
Can't you have something as well?
Oh, no. No, I'm too tense to eat. I'm living on my nerves.
So Dad's out looking for Hattie Sutton?
Yes.
After all she did?
Well, I told him that he had to go. He had to be seen to be doing the right thing.
But he was thrilled.
James, there's something on your dad's computer he doesn't want me to see.
What would that be?
Well, I don't know, do I? If I knew, then I wouldn't have to look.
Just ask him when he gets back.
Well, look, I'm trying to protect your father from himself. And I'm not asking you to get involved or to take sides. Just need his password.
I'm bloody believable, Mum.
Come on, Linus, open up, will ya? I'm sorry, I shouldn't have done it, but it was a gut thing, a reaction, you know? Like a reflex. I don't know what happened there, but I promise it'll never happen again. Can you open the door?
I want to see your face.
Just open it, just a crack. Can you do that, Linus? Please? Hey, look, I've made breakfast for you. Don't let it get cold. I'll see you later, mate, all right?
Thank you.
Hi, Linus. DS Mills. Can we talk about Hattie Sutton?
My dad's at work.
Well, that's all right. We can have a chat, Colton. So how long you been neighbours?
Since I was born.
Do you know Hattie well?
No.
Do you know Caitlin?
A bit.
Was she happy at home?
Oh, you must be able to hear everything through these walls. I mean, any arguments, any fights? How about you? Any fights?
A disagreement.
At home?
School.
So why is that then? Lunch money? Girl?
They think I'm gay.
Oh. Okay, well, thank you for your time. You've got school now, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry if I made you late. If you don't mind me asking, is that your mum?
I was on duty the night she died. Really tragic.
Okay, well, I'll drop by this evening and see if I can catch your dad.
Police.
Hello, police. How can I help?
It's about my dad.
Do you have an incident to report? Hello?
What?
Good morning.
Coffee.
Thank you.
Oi. What's the matter with Charlie?
Oh, it's her lost rabbit.
I'll have a look for it.
It's not the toy she's upset about. I mean, she is, but she's worried about Hattie.
Okay. Yeah.
Wonder how Richard and Joe are getting on.
You smell so good.
Must be praying she's going to come back any minute.
She will.
I can't imagine how awful it must be for them.
It's unimaginable.
Yeah.
Hey, it's all right. Why don't we go upstairs for a minute?
Text from Meg. There's a search in the woods for Hattie this morning.
You're not thinking of going?
All my friends are.
Fee, 100 amateurs trampling all over a possible crime scene.
I'm not a bloody amateur. I can make sure it's done properly. I might even find her.
Look, I know you want to go and you think it's your job, but it's not anymore.
No. You're right.
Sorry.
Well, that's all right.
Fiona.
Yeah.
You looking well?
Thanks. Must be very dirty.
Just need a doing.
You live next door to the Suttons, don't you?
Yeah.
How are they coping?
I could hear Joe wailing all night. Right through the wall.
That's awful.
Didn't get a wink of sleep.
Poor you.
Do you mind?
Sorry.
Oh, I'll let you get on, sorry.
It's all up. What for?
Well, Richard said the police thing that Hattie might have run off with some older bloke she met online.
Is?
No, they're not saying.
No, but if we find him in there, Richard wants us to give him a slap.
Right. Okay. Right, what am I looking for?
Anything to do with Carol's field.
No, you'll have to be more specific.
Well, that Village Green campaign that Hattie Sutton organised.
Okay. Village Green campaign. Here's the website. Forum. It's all old.
Any abusive messages?
Yeah, and they're all about Dad. I don't think you should read this, Mum. You'll only get upset.
No, no, I want to see if there's anything that might have set him off.
What do you mean, set him off?
I don't know. Or maybe he saw Hattie on her bike and he gave her a little nudge, you know, just to give her a fright, and she fell badly. I don't know. An accident that went wrong.
Why do you always have to imagine the worst-case scenario for everything? Is your life really so boring that you have to see death and horror around every corner? It's not normal, Mum.
Is this normal?
Bit of hush, please. 18 hours missing. We found a crown of flowers in the woods last night. She could still be out there. Is she trapped? Is she injured? Is she hiding? Does she not want to come home because of all the fuss? We need her to know that we don't care about that. We just want her home with her family. Now, I hope you've all checked your gardens and your sheds and your outbuildings.
Yeah.
That's great. And we thank you for that.
Hi, guys. Hi. Just
got
in time.
A lot of land out here.
Oh, no.
A lot of ground to cover.
Who put him in charge? Sure he's an idiot. Footwear. He seems to be doing all right. It's a good turnout. I arrested him once.
But I wouldn't be sending any of you out there.
He's in dispute over a parking permit. Pissed in a council letterbox.
No.
Got it all on CCTV.
Stick to the paths, and if you see anything at all, you tell me first. Make sure you got the command number before you go.
What an idiot.
Let's move out.
Let's go!
See, we should be going in lines, taking our time, covering every inch. It's a shambles. Come on.
Prime suspect. There you are, living next door, knowing she's only on the other side of the wall, pulling down her panties, showering.
And you're weird. Living in your own bubble, keeping to yourself.
What's your point, Sherlock?
That you couldn't take the tease anymore. You had to do it. I get that. She was a bitch. It was due.
If you tell me, I can help you. I'll get your back.
Thanks. I'm not a murderer. And I don't want to join your gang. Why are they?
Everyone's out searching. I've been watching them go by all morning, mothers with their kids. I mean, how messed up is that? Come on, son, let's go find a body. I'll tell you something else. None of them are gonna get their rentals back on time today. And I'm offering no amnesty. Except for the Suttons, I mean, you know. They've had to meet their parents for 2 days, but gonna let that slide because of the circumstances.
My dad wouldn't give a shit if I'm missing.
It's a bit harsh.
I don't know him at all. Seriously. I don't know what he does. Where he goes every day. I don't know who his friends are. I've no idea who he is.
Hey, probably feels the same way about you, man. I mean, how often do you tell him about your life?
He lies to me. I know he does. He doesn't answer properly if I ask him anything. And I always feel like he's hiding something from me.
The man has got his problems like everyone else. Get to know him.
Yeah. I'll die trying.
Please, Tina.
Linus, your face.
I'm fine. I can still sing and dance.
Has anyone had a look at it?
I have. I gave myself a clean bill of health.
No, that won't do. Medical room, now.
Or Miss Biology.
Excuse me. I'm going to need the details of every member of staff and pupil with the initials MDN.
Linda will sort that out for you. You follow me. Who did this to you?
Oh, don't worry about me. Worry about the other guys. Stay easy. Whew. Touch and go.
Look at your hands. Not a mark on them.
Still watching those cop shows, eh?
Who hit you?
You have soft, warm hands, Tina. You know, I have other bruises I could show you. But not here.
Bump on the head hasn't changed you, then?
They're both still beautiful.
I want you to wait outside, okay? I'm gonna sort this out.
Sort what out?
Thank you.
was Hattie Sutton's bike?
I've no idea. Looks new.
Yeah, could be. Oh.
Like it might be nothing. We can't jump to conclusions. People scrape their cars all the time.
Oh. Hello, Sandra. Yeah, it's tragic, poor girl. Yeah, no, I'd be happy to help. Yeah, it'd be a pleasure. Bye. You have to get your own lunch. I've got to go and make teas for the Rotary Club.
Staring at me. Staring and whispering. Some of them are actually taking pictures. No way for me to cry or freak out. I'm like something in a zoo. And I'm the one who gets sent out because apparently I'm causing a distraction.
Well, the same thing happened to me and my mum died. Tragedy sticks to you. Makes people stare. Makes your friends avoid you. And you can never shake it off.
I don't even feel like I live in the same world as them now.
You don't. Who's in the end?
I don't know, why?
I saw Everett Newcomb at the petrol station this morning.
Oh? How did he look? He used to be pretty fit.
Same, really, just older.
How come my husband gains 2 stone and goes bald and Everett gets to look exactly the same?
Something about him really put me on edge.
He probably fancied you.
Oh. Do you think?
Well, if Alan still isn't up for it.
Actually, he is up for it all of a sudden.
Oh, well, that's great. What fixed him?
I don't know. I think maybe it was stress.
Well, in the nick of time, we wouldn't want you running off with Everett, would we?
No offence, Fee, but you're way too old for him.
You're in the same year at college, actually.
Yeah, no, he hasn't had a serious relationship since Lisa died.
That's really sad. Their little boy was so young when it happened.
Fell down the stairs.
Terrible accident.
No such thing as an accident. There's always someone to blame.
You think everyone's guilty of something?
Because they usually are.
Well, he's not a lonely widower. Lots of flings, usually with girls a lot younger than him.
How young?
I saw him with a girl in the pub last summer. She can't have been more than 20.
Blonde?
Always.
Well, we both know who did this to you.
We do?
Just tell me.
Okay. Appreciate your concern, but this is a private matter.
Why are you protecting them?
Them.
The only way to stop Jaden and Leon is by speaking out.
It wasn't Jaden and Leon.
Come on, Linus, I'm not stupid.
You're a good form tutor, Miss Nabai. You try your best, and I respect that. But honestly, you have shitty instincts. No one sees what we see. So no one can help us. We're on our own.
Thank you.
we find whoever's taken her. And not the police.
What are you talking about?
If the police find him, the first thing they do is give him his rights to a cup of tea. I tell you what, girl, I don't want £40,000 of taxpayers' money spent on keeping him in a private cell with TV and internet.
And what would you suggest?
If they find him in the woods and he never leaves the woods, I won't mind at all. If you know what I mean.
How very medieval of you, Sandra.
Biblical, actually.
My son's been missing for 3.5 years, so I know what Richard's going through.
What happened to him?
Been round you?
Yeah.
It's his mother. She left me and took him. And I can't find him anywhere, and the family won't tell me anything.
What did you do that was so bad?
No idea, mate.
So it's not the same then, is it? I mean, you know your son's alive and well, you just don't know his address.
It is the same. Did you do anything to get him back? Hattie!
I can't work out where the inn is.
Yeah, me neither.
Really?
Yeah, I was cleaning none of my business.
Thought twins talked about everything.
We used to when we were little, but last year she got into Carol's Fields and I didn't. Like, we stopped talking after that. So I didn't even know if she was interested in someone.
Who do you think she'd like?
Someone really perfect. Who wants to save the world.
What about the opposite? A dirty secret, someone she had to hide. And, like, someone she shouldn't like.
Nathan Naismith?
No. Neil Dewin.
Mr. Dewin, geography, no.
Natalie Nixon?
Yeah, it wouldn't be a girl. How much I do know about her.
Someone from our school, then.
I mean, maybe someone from the protest. James, is he home?
No. I really need to speak to him.
Why? What have you found?
I'm sure it's nothing. I'm sure Dad can explain it. Just try and find him.
Yeah,
clean
yeah.
Him up.
Okay.
Bye.
Yeah, bye. Little baby Jesus. Guardian angels or earth spirits, whoever's helped them, please. Please, if you help me this time, I promise I'll never ask for anything again.
You don't want to go this way.
We do, actually.
We're looking for Hattie Sutton.
Well, I can tell you, she's not down here.
You've looked, have you?
Yes. Besides, it's not safe. There are badger sets. Don't need you disturbing them. Off you go.
Comfy.
Actually, I'm gonna go back there.
No, he said it's not safe.
I don't believe him. Assistance at the moon pond.
Where are they going? Something's happened.
Oi!
Jesus, is that her?
We need to create a perimeter. It's a crime scene.
What made you think to look in there?
I was told not to.
By who?
Malcolm Spicer.
Malcolm Spicer?
That's what I thought.
Good work, PC Hill. Like the old days.
Why are there police?
They found Hattie in the moon pond.
Oh, no. She's dead. Poor girl. Her poor family.
It's our job to comfort Sandra, not to need comforting.
What kind of a man would drown a child like that? It's evil. Pure evil.
Back, please. Keep behind the yellow line.
What's going on?
Well, nothing that concerns you, sir. I suggest you go home.
No, mate, I'm in charge of the searches for Hattie Sutton.
Right, well, we're in charge now.
If she's in there, I have a right to know.
Yeah, if she's in there, there's nothing you can do. Let us take care of it.
Did you watch her grow up? You spent time with her at Christmas. How are you going to take
Look,
care
I'm
of
sorry,
her?
Look, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to ask you
Don't
to
bloody
leave.
Touch
Don't
me!
Don't watch your language, sir.
I'll say what I like and I do what I like.
Wait, come in!
Hey! Have to go. Malcolm? Malcolm! Malcolm, I've been out of my mind. Sorry.
What were you saying?
Thank you.
God.
Yeah, but the clothing could still be significant.
Stuck. Oh.
Hi, Mum.
You're stuck, are you? Oh, look, right, my ball. No.
No, I'm going to kick you.
Got your message. Where did you go?
I went on a search. Sorry. Thanks for picking up the kids.
It's all right. Did you find something?
Found clothes. At the moon pond.
Is it hurt?
The family are coming to identify them. We're not going to find her alive.
You okay?
No.
Oh, okay. It's all right.
You were right. Shouldn't have gone.
No. You had to go. It's who you are. Look, I'm going to run you a nice hot bath.
What have you got there?
Oh, this is George.
Is that Daddy's old bear?
Yeah, Dad gave it to me to cheer me up.
Oh, sweet.
No, it's not. It's horrible. It has no eyes.
Where did you find it?
In the loft.
Poor George.
What are you doing up there?
The light was on.
The light was on? What's that? No, it's not. It's a bird's nest.
Is it?
Yeah. What else could it be? It's probably a sparrow's. Where did you find it?
It's just by the light.
Yeah. Looks new. I'll put it back, shall I? You all right?
Fine.
Okay. Yeah. There we go.
Yeah, they're just sweet girls, you know. Average, happy, sweet girls.
Yeah, anything unusual about either of them?
I'm not a big fan of local gossip or chatting over the fence.
You've been neighbours for years, you must have heard something.
Not really. You know, people know I'm not interested, so they don't tell me anything.
Colonel, what about boyfriends? People hanging around?
teenagers, do you? And I think it's best not to, like, with my son. It's a case of a benign blind eye.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
But I say, Hattie always struck me as a sensible girl, very grown up for her age. She's more of an adult than me.
I know well.
That's just the impression that she gave me. I can't say I ever spoke to her that often.
Okay, well, thanks for your help. If you do think of anything, please don't hesitate to give me a call.
How close are you to finding her?
That's a rapidly developing situation.
Linus, where have you been?
Out.
School called me this morning. They said you walked out. Been worried about you all day.
Worried about me?
Hi, Linus.
Go wash your hands. Get yourself cleaned up.
He still gets himself filthy. Like he's
10 years old.
Oh, thanks for your time, Mr. Newton.
No problem. Don't run off like that again. I thought you were never going to come back.
And don't hit me again.
Scout's on her.
You weren't a scout.
Hey, I don't want to argue about it, okay? I'm gonna make us dinner, yeah? Kill the fatted calf and all that shit.
Okay, so I got a call today. The girl who spat blood at me has made a complaint.
What?
She's claiming I used excessive force.
How much force?
Look, she sobered up in her cell. Couldn't remember where all the cuts and bruises came from, so she decided to lawyer up and blame me. I don't want you to worry about it. It won't become a thing.
How can you be sure?
She's a little drunk with a long history of previous.
You've been suspended?
Yeah, of course. I'll make the best of it. Get a few jobs done around the house. You've got goosebumps.
What, you don't find this funny anymore?
You used to love this show. When I was 8.
People cracking their nuts is always funny.
Dad, why were you being interviewed by the police?
I wasn't being interviewed, they were just asking around.
Didn't ask me anything?
Well, you're not a responsible member of this community.
Oh, and you are. I want to know how Mum died.
I don't talk about it. And you don't ask about it.
I couldn't find your father. Lisa found Hattie's clothes in the moon pond.
Mum, you need to come upstairs.
Did you hear me? Her clothes in a bloody pond in the woods by the bird hide.
Upstairs now.
Police found a raggy old slip and brought it round to show Mum, thinking it was Hattie's. Mum was so upset she couldn't look at it, so I had to.
Is it hers?
Like she wear polyester. It was such a horrible thing. It was kind of hilarious they think it was hers. And everyone's been so serious. And I started laughing because Hattie would have found it funny too. I'm in disgrace again. My parents think I'm this callous cow. I think I don't care that she's gone.
I saw my mum today.
What were you doing wrong?
I'm not sure.
A long, 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 long time ago, when this town was just a tiny village, and the woods were all around, people who lived here believed in fairies and elves and goblins. And the years went past, and the town grew bigger, bigger. We had houses and cars and electricity, and we forgot all about the fairies and the elves and the goblins. But fairies and the elves and the goblins like to remind us that they're still here. Steal my car keys, and they hide Mummy's scissors.
And they came here and took Mr. Johnson? I don't think so, Dad.
Oh, I think so. Listen. They're just playing a game with you. So you don't have to be sad. Just play along.
I didn't know you believed in magic.
Well, it's a lot of things you don't know about me. Okay.
Night, Dad.
Good night, darling.
What am I looking at?
Dad's business accounts, your joint accounts, your savings.
Well, what's this got to do with anything?
It's all gone, Mum. All the money went into Carol's field, the legal battles, proposal, it's all gone.
But this is business money.
No, it's everything. The house, the boat, the car. You don't own a damn thing. He gambled a lot on Carol's field, and he knew it. He's been trying to dig himself out of this hole for months, but it's collapsed now.
Because of Hattie Sutton and the Village Green campaign.
She ruined him.
Seth.
You wrapped Justice in there.
No, they gave me a caution.
I've got something to show you.
They found it closed this afternoon.
Yeah, it's not clothes, it's something bigger.
I just want to go home and have a shower and a pint.
It's in the woods. You have to see it. Into the abyss, and the abyss looks back at you.
A girl has gone missing, and people are looking for someone to blame.
I do pray that what happened to your father has nothing to do with Addison.
You know what he's done! You know what Hattie is!
No.
Let me in!
How am I gonna do this?
Just keep your answers simple and look them straight in the eye.
Everything you see here, it's all been an illusion. None of this is real.
It's you, Linus.
Did you ever see Hattie talking to a guy called Everett?
Everett, of course.